Embattled televangelist Apollo Quiboloy speaking out on the Senate's probe into abuse allegations against him. Let's get details now from our correspondent, Sherianne Torres. Sherianne, go ahead.
Yes, Carmina. Kingdom of Jesus Christ pastor Apollo Quiboloy breaks his silence today and junks allegations that he has been raping his women followers for years. In a recorded voice statement shared to journalists by the KJOC, Quiboloy claims that those women who are accusing him of rape are actually, quote-unquote, fighting over him because he is single and rich. These women, he says, are all wanting to be his wife, so they will eventually get his wealth, which Quiboloy adds will never happen because he is a dedicated servant of God. And for failing to get what they want, he said, these women accepted bribes and are now accusing him of rape. The 74-year-old Quiboloy says he doesn't want to show his face because he has so many threats. Quiboloy's pronouncement was in response to the testimony of alleged former KOGC female members before the Senate Committee on Women, Children, Family Relations, and Gender Equality. In those two hearings, two batches of alleged former KOGC members claimed that they were offered to the pastor by senior pastoral members of KJOC months after joining the ministry. Some of these women, a number of them are foreigners, claimed that they were raped by Quiboloy even before their 18th birthday. In the same recorded message, Quiboloy's voice started to break while addressing allegations that he's ordering his members to beg. He admits that his followers are soliciting, but insists that such quote-unquote sacrifice stems from their desire to help the poor. Quiboloy says every single stab or centavo they give to poor communities and areas affected by disasters or calamities, and his volunteers are doing all this for free. He also says that it's not his fault if he is rich because all the things that he possesses today, he uses to help the needy. The religious leader, Carmina, meantime, reiterates his challenge to Senator Risa Ontiveros, who is leading the investigation on his alleged human trafficking and children and women abuse, to charge him in court. He also declares that he will not attend the Senate hearing and will exhaust all the means to defend himself. Ontiveros, in reaction, tells Quiboloy not to play like he is the victim. What's only being asked from him, according to Ontiveros, is for Quiboloy to attend the next Senate hearing, which is on March 5. Ontiveros warns Quiboloy not to snub the next hearing or she will have him arrested. That's the latest, Carmina. Back to you.
Thanks a lot, Sherianne Torres there joining us on the line. And Vice President and Education Secretary Sara Duterte shrugging off allegations linking her to controversial pastor Apollo Quiboloy. Joyce Balancho tells us more.
Mga kababayan.
Vice President Sara Duterte posted a video message online in response to allegations made by a former member of the Kingdom of Jesus Christ. During Monday's Senate hearing, the former member said the group's leader, Pastor Apollo Quiboloy, would bring bags containing guns to his property in Glory Mountain. He also claimed that former President Rodrigo Duterte and his daughter, then Davao City Mayor Sara Duterte, would also go there and collect the guns. The Vice President and concurrent Education Secretary did not directly address the allegations, only saying she has anticipated the attacks against her. She also vowed to focus on serving the Filipino people.
Hindi ko ikakagulat kung dumami pa ang mga kaso, imbestigasyon, testigo paratang atake at paninira laban sa akin sa mga susunod na araw, linggo, buwan at mga taon. Naniniwala ako na may tamang panahon para sa lahat. Panahon ngayon ng aking pagtatrabaho. Tutuparin ko ang sinumpaang tungkulin. Uunahin ko ang mga tunay na suliranin. Uunahin ko ang Pilipino.
The Vice President's father, former President Duterte, has yet to issue a statement on the allegations against him. Meanwhile, a lawmaker warns Quiboloy may face arrest if he will not appear in the next House hearing on the alleged franchise violations by media network SMNI.
Upon if next hearing, absent po ulit siya, I would say I think ready po yung committee to seek pono for to cite in contempt and seek the subsequent arrest.
House lawmakers urged the embattled pastor to attend the next hearing scheduled on March 12 to shed light on issues hounding the network.
We don't take issuance of subpoena lightly. We only issue subpoenas if there is a deliberate dismissal or rejection or ignoring the invitation of the House of Representatives. That's the last recourse. And his presence is very, very vital in the ongoing committee hearings para mas makita yung buong picture po ng pagdating po doon sa usapin ng violations ng SMNI.
Many believe Kiboloy owns SMNI, but the network's lawyers deny this. Both the House and Senate has issued a subpoena for Kiboloy. Joyce Balancho, ABS-CBN News.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. asserts the country won't cooperate with the International Criminal Court's probe into his predecessor's bloody drug war. This despite a recent survey showing over half of Filipinos want the Philippines to participate in the investigation.
It's not about the evidence. It's about the jurisdiction of the ICC in the Philippines.
This is what President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. said when asked if he would reconsider his stance of cooperating with International Criminal Court investigators after a survey from SWS showed that over half of Filipinos are in favor of the ICC's investigation on human rights violations committed during the previous administration's drug war. Over half of the respondents also hope that the government will cooperate with the ICC.
They can produce as much evidence as they want, but they cannot act upon it in the Philippines. Still those questions of jurisdictions and sovereignty that I haven't yet seen a sufficient answer for. And until then, I do not recognize their jurisdiction in the Philippines.
Marcos, however, said that ICC investigators would not be stopped from entering the Philippines if they haven't done anything illegal. Former Senator Sonny Trillanes had claimed ICC investigators were in the country December last year to conduct their probe into the bloody drug war of the Duterte administration. Several House members also joined the call for the president to have the Philippines rejoin the ICC.
It's all about sending the correct signals sa ating mga foreign friends and investors. We want to show them we respect and uphold the rule of law, human rights.
I think this current administration is conscious on data-driven studies. Yung mga surveys, in mga research. Sabi nga ng mga kasamahan ko dito, ang gobyerno at ang administration, sino man ang nakupo, ay responsive dapat sa mga pulso ng bayan.
The entry of ICC investigators in the Philippines has been a sensitive topic affecting the alliance between the president and members of the Duterte family, as former President Rodrigo Duterte is at risk of being the subject of investigations or even an arrest if ICC personnel will be allowed to pursue the case in the Philippines. Political analyst Ronald Yama says how Marcos Jr. will handle the ICC issue will affect the president's political capital, especially in the upcoming 2025 midterm elections, as the former president still enjoys the support of his mass base.
He is a big, big threat. Capital B-I-G. Dahil nga, meron pa siyang latent support, hindi lamang sa mamamayan, kundi sa mga key institutions sa ating gobyerno. Halimbawa, yung military at saka police. The camp of Duterte ay hindi pwedeng i-underestimate. The camp of Duterte has a lot of weapons at their disposal kahit hindi sila incumbent. Mm-hmm. So, kailangan i-confront ito immediately, decisively ng presidente at manip in the bud itong mga threats na ito.
The Justice Department earlier claimed that they have yet to receive information that ICC's investigators have already entered the Philippines.